DePauw School of Music is wrapping up their season with recitals and concerts galore.
Voting is open for DSG, and it is your job to make your voice heard.
And Tigers, we know what you're all thinking. Yes, it is finally everyone's favorite week of the year. It's Little Five, and we have the 411 on all of the events that you can look forward to.
Trust me, there's more activities than you guys are ready for. Personally, I am so excited. Because it's my first Little Five.
It's
so,
my last Little Five.
Oh. So let's dive right into this week's happenings for tonight's episode of The Source.
And the last episode of The Source for the semester. Holy cow, time flies. Am I right?
Absolutely. My freshman year's over. Your 4 years are over.
Oh, God.
I mean, maybe I shouldn't have brought that up on air. But
yeah, not now.
Okay.
But hey, I'm Megan.
And I'm Andrew. Let's get started.
With the end of the school year comes plenty of recitals to close the amazing DePauw School of Music season. First up, percussion and saxophone's final show will be this Saturday at 7:30 in Kresge. Next up is DePauw University Band's final performance on Sunday at 4 p.m. Also in Kresge, and finally, DePauw Choir and Orchestra will be performing next Sunday, May 5th, also at 4 p.m. in Kresge. Along with all of these shows, amazing seniors are putting on their senior recitals, and you can check Campus Labs for an abundance of these great performances where students get to showcase their talents. Come out and support your DePauw School of Music students that have been preparing for these recitals all year long.
I mean, you hear so much about the School of Music, and you know at least one person that's in the School of Music. So
everybody does.
Why not come out and support them? I mean,
absolutely.
They've been working so hard
They're
all year long.
Talented.
Absolutely, more talented than me. Okay, good. I'm glad we're on the same page. Voting for DePauw Student Government and the Board of Trustees ends on Monday, the 29th, on Campus Labs. The Student Government acts as an advocate for the student body and helps implement new policies, improve the quality of the DePauw experience, and overall affects positive change throughout campus. So do your part in making the school a better place and vote for DePauw's next leaders.
Right on. As another school year comes to an end, seniors are finishing up their degrees with seminar presentations and final theses. And for studio art majors, their last few months have been spent designing, creating, and finally showcasing their senior art exhibits. Each of the studio art majors will have their work displayed in Peeler until Saturday, May 18th. If you want to see the work of some very talented Tigers and future artists, be sure to check it out.
I mean, we have musicians and we have artists. What
and
more?
We have anchors.
Anchors, that would be us. Perfect. Now, this is an interesting event for sure. This Sunday from 1 to 4, there will be a filmmaking workshop in the Tenzer Center. However, there's a twist. The workshop will use a 360-degree camera to explore the limits of and freedoms of filmmaking. The event will be led by a DePauw alum, Alex Thompson, and will consist of a short intro section before the participants are divided into teams to make their own videos using the cool new technology. The videos will then be analyzed and screened in the Tenzer Center video wall. And this certainly looks like a neat event, and if you're interested, check Campus Labs for more details.
That does sound cool.
So like when you're filming, is it gonna get you in the shot too? Because
it's 360, yeah.
Well, like I mean, I don't think I got a nice
here.
Like filming face, because I'm usually like, you know, like when your mom's taking a picture of you and she's like this sort of thing.
She gets all eight of your chins.
Yeah, exactly.
But hey, Tigers, the sun's coming out. It's nearly impossible to get a bike at Lilly, and students are getting antsy. You know what that means?
What does it mean?
It's finally Little Five. This week-long event dates back to 1956 and is modeled after the famous 500-mile auto race held at the Indianapolis Speedway each Memorial Day. If this is your first Little Five, here's what you can expect. On Friday, the street sprints will begin at 5 p.m. on Anderson Street. Make sure to get there early if you want a good spot to watch the race. And then on Saturday, alumni will kick off the crit at 11 a.m., followed by the women's race at 1 and the men's race at 2:30. Get ready for a big weekend, Tigers.
I don't think I'm ready.
I know I'm not. It's going to be fun, though.
From experience, right?
Yeah.
Great. Along with the main cycling event, word on the street is that there are some pretty cool activities occurring for students throughout the entire weekend. The area near Rector Village at the time of the street sprints, we will have a Ferris wheel, food trucks, dairy castle, bounce houses, and dunk tanks galore. I mean, I don't know what else you could ask for. That's a whole lot of entertainment right there. Plus, if you'd like to say hi to some D3 TV, WGRE, or the DePauw members at 5:30, there will be a student media block party in that area with food and merch from your favorite campus media providers. It's looking to be a great weekend, Tigers, so have fun and stay safe.
Well, you can count me in for sure. I may be swamped with final projects and papers, but Little Five is just a weekend that you cannot miss. But speaking of finals, it's probably time for us to sign off and hit the books. So thank you for tuning in this semester. It has been a pleasure giving you all of your DePauw news. We hope you'll tune back in again in the fall.
It really has been a great semester, and all of us here at D3 TV want to wish you guys the best of luck on your finals and a wonderful summer wherever your adventures will take you. We'll see you in a few. I'm Andrew.
And I'm Megan.
Good night.
And goodbye, Tigers.
Goodbye, Tigers. I freaking love D3 TV.